never met a boy.
Anyway.
Hi, I'm Detective Sipowicz.
Hi, I'm the new detective's administrative aide, Donna Avendando.
I have to say that three times real fast.
Yeah, I know. Those two together, they're quite a mouthful.
Amen to that. You mind if I stick with Donna?
Not at all. Anyway, any typing or filing you want done, that's what I'm here for.
Well, that's the best news I've heard all day. Welcome.
Thanks. Is he okay?
I'm sorry, this is Detective Medavoy.
Pleased to meet you.
Detective Medavoy has taken a vow of silence till they sort out this mess in Bosnia. Well, it's been nice meeting you, Donna, and don't worry about it. If he wants anything, he'll leave a note.
How long have you been waiting to say that to me?
First thing I thought of when I woke up. Hey, Sarge.
It took one in the chest. No sign of a struggle. My guess, for what it's worth, they either took him by surprise or they shot him from a distance.
Anything missing?
I'll check with the girls.
All right, make sure your men secure the crime scene.
Is that going to be the last one today, or you got a few more saved up?
No, that's it.
Good.
What do we got?
Name's Oscar.
NYPD.
Sorry.
No, it's no problem. Did you know your neighbor, Janelle Woodruff?
Not really. I heard she died.
Yeah, unfortunately. We're trying. I'm sorry. My name is Detective Clark. This is my partner, Detective Sipowicz.
Hi.
How's it going?
And your name?
Marlisa Diaz.
Marlisa, hi. So what we need is to get into Janelle's apartment.
I don't have a key. I really didn't talk to her much.
Do you know anybody else who does have a key, I mean, to her apartment?
No, she really kept to herself.
Is there a super in the building?
I haven't seen him, but I just moved here a month ago.
Isn't that right? Yeah, where are you from?
Philadelphia.
Yeah, that's great.
My nephew is a big Sixers fan.
You might want to try Janelle's son, Michael.
How old's Michael?
13.
Oh, are you in school?
No, I usually see him hanging out at the basketball courts off of Catherine Street. He sells bottles of water out of a bag.
Medavoy, why don't you and Jones go ahead and take that?
A couple of quick questions. Does he sell water only, or does he maybe sell sodas?
Greg? Anything else you can think of?
No, I'm sorry. Can I go back inside now?
Sure, absolutely, yeah.
I love her.
Hey, you're my guest. People actually swim in there?
This cart's from a grocery store 4 blocks away.
That means nothing. I seen bums push them carts to Brooklyn and back till the wheels fell off.
Anyways, let's get back to work. Don't want to have a personal conversation here or nothing.
All right, try and get some prints off her and whoever else might have been pushing that cart. Let's go talk to Johnny Weissmuller over here.
Wally Mooring?
When was the last time you had a tetanus shot, Wally?
A couple of months ago. Hepatitis A, too, so I'm good. I'm training for the Manhattan Island Marathon just to get used to the water chop and the flotsam and stuff.
Hey, can we get somebody to put something on this guy, a blanket or something?
How'd you find her, Wally?
She was just there when I got out of the water.
You here yesterday, too?
Hey, every morning this week. She wasn't here yesterday.
Uncle.
Owner says the guy comes walking up, keels over. Stabbed through the eye, looks like.
Where is he?
The owner?
No, his third cousin.
I get him.
A big guy. Tom Vogel, 32.
Lives up the street.
Prakash Sangdahara, nice to meet you.
Yeah, same here. Can you tell us what you saw?
If I do, you move the body so I can have my customers again? Just kidding, of course. he comes stumbling down the street with his hand over his eye and falls down.
He being chased by anyone?
I did not see that.
You seen him around before?
No, but when I die, I hope I die in front of his business so he loses all his morning customers. I'm kidding.
All right. Thanks for the help.
How long to move the man? Now I'm being serious.
It'll get moved when we're done here.
We can't move him around the corner? I could grab his feet. You grab his hand. We'll move him ourselves. I'm kidding.
Get back into your store right now. You understand me? Get in there, pal.
Yeah, sorry.
Chris Aguilar gave you up. Said he owed you a favor.
That's crazy. You tell Chris. Okay, you got me.
Been a bad boy. I'll make sure I don't eat dessert tonight.
I know about favors.
Oh, you do, huh?
Yeah. When I was in uniform, I was partnered with this guy, Kurt Kreitzer. We were looking for a guy who held up a liquor store. We turned this corner. Kurt thought he saw someone, so he fires a shot. Turns out it was a woman, a civilian.
Wow, fascinating.
The woman was grazed, and I talked her out of filing a complaint. After that, Kurt was too skittish to be a cop, but he owed me a favor.
Listen, today was great. I haven't had this much fun since, hell, I don't know when.
Adalo, you've been giving me the runaround all day. You had somebody killed. At least you could hear my story.
Screw your story. Screw your buddy, Kurt. Screw you.
Now, Kurt, he wanted a job where he knew who the good guys were and who the bad guys were.
Oh, I get it. You came back because you want what Neil wanted. Some young Latin boys. But you can't come right out and say it.
So he left the police force, and he went into corrections. Good guys, bad guys. And he's done really well for himself. Moved up to deputy commissioner of administration for all the pens in the state. He's who I was going to call to get you transferred closer to home, back when I thought that we were going to treat each other civil.
Why don't you get lost, man?
Wendy Correctional Facility, Alden, New York, a half hour from the Canadian border, 10 hours from here. They call it the icebox, Adalo. So you have your family send earmuffs for those days where it gets 10 below in the yard. And you are there for the rest of your life.
Oh, so you're trying to run a game on me now.
Game's been run, dickhead. You ship out tomorrow. Wrong cop.
Seven male Hispanic DOAs, all of them naked.
Six of them shot, one with his throat cut. They're taped up and the door's broken.
Back up a minute. They were naked?
Buck naked.
They made him strip, then killed him.
Got him stripped naked, yeah.
Unless they were already naked.
Why would they have been naked already?
Some possible nude sex cult aspect.
Wasn't a stitch of clothing in the apartment.
So you got no IDs.
Crime scene's taken all the prints off the dead bodies now.
We located the landlord. He rented the place 2 months ago to a Joe Rodriguez who paid cash.
Was he clothed at the time? Any of the DOAs him?
No, we had the landlord look at the bodies. He didn't recognize the guy who rented the place.
Any sign of drugs?
No, but a padlock closet was broken into.
How do we know her father didn't Welsh end the dowry? Maybe she was seen eating at one of his fast days or something. Anybody hear a dog howling?
I don't find that especially funny.
Detective squad.
How about that haircut, huh? Like Rod Steiger, one of them Roman movies.
Yeah. How do you spell that?
How you making out?
I don't know, kid. I can't sit down. I'm trying to figure out if a soda's worth having my next two birthdays on these stairs.
What kind of soda you want? I'm on my way back down.
Excuse me. Cherry.
Diet or regular?
What are you, smart ass?
No.
Regular.